Hello everyone, welcome back to XCOM 2 with me, Flick. Let's jump back into the map and see what's happening. What's this? Again, I don't really need those. I've got crap tons of alloys and Illyrium. So we'll ignore that. I think we're probably just going to make contact and aim to start getting towards the only black site on the mission. There was one of those pop-up events for intel, right? I want more intel just purely because then I can trade it for supplies. And we're almost at a new month as well, so that means he'll restock. Although actually, we're almost at a new month, so finish making contact so I get more supplies when the month changes over. I think also the intel event actually depopped. Despawned, I guess. It pops and then it despawns. Rapid response. So, aliens approved their threat response. Guaranteed reinforcements on Guerrilla Ops. You only ever get one Guerrilla Op per month though, don't you? Alright, so our backup PsyOp, who we might need to use today depending on what I do, now has Solace, so that's the AoE buff. Continue training. I would very much like you to get... Fuse is so fun, but go for Void Rift. And now I know that Void Rift is not a permanent mind control, which is why it can work on multiple people. It lasts 2 or 3 turns. Please finish before the end of the month. Yes. Get one in there. Also, I have a Steam pop-up that's getting in the way of my OBS window, so I'm going to have to minimize the game in a second real quick. Because I need to make sure everything's recording fine. I can't see my audio levels or the game's audio levels, so hang on. Let me just click off the monitor. It might freeze for a second here. Also, tell Discord I am recording. There we are. Good. So we do have access to that black site. I kind of rather that it had another pip available. Was there a intel thing? Also, we have max contacts. Oh, I started building a relay over there and I never finished it. How many days are left in the month? I might have time depending on how long it takes me to fly over here. I might as well finish building that relay I started, because that will also give me more supplies when the month passes over. I know there's other areas of the map I haven't connected to, but as long as a black site never gets built there, I don't actually need to worry about spending intel on making
Priority
contact
message
people.
Coming through,
there's
Commander.
The end of the month, proccy.
Putting it on screen now. You have made considerable
556,
progress.
Very nice. That should cover my expenses
over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing.
So this month we're going to have to try and stop poison rounds again, reduce their counter by 2 weeks, or just stop the Avatar progress by one pip. Also imminent, so yeah, we might do the retaliation that I've been talking about for like 4 weeks. Good, okay, yes, thank you. Yes, although I imagine the retaliation thing will proc before I get all of this. Yeah, just, you know, just saunter over the sea. Take your time, we've got forever. I do still need the excavation to finish though, which is actually about to finish. Okay. View the room.
Maximum power consumption reached.
Shield of power coil, significant increased power output. Oh, it takes 12
power
days to build though.
Construction initiated.
Would you like to assign them there? Okay. Ah, I forgot it wasn't taking into consideration putting someone on it. So 6 days. And that's actually all the Avenger cleared out. So now we have engineers doing bugger all. How many supplies do I have? I still only have 108. Oh right, I can train another soldier because Soul Food's busy right now. What can I do in here? Retrain soldier abilities. Oh, I didn't know you could do this. So I could actually have maybe made someone a Psy Operative who already existed. That's good to know for future playthroughs, I guess. What do I need for the Shadow Chamber? I still need this Power Chamber to finish in 200 supplies. Alright, we'll just sit on everything else. I mean, we will get enough from here if it lets me get them. So I guess Soulfood has recovered and he's got Schism. That's why he didn't have it on last mission, he hadn't quite finished getting it. So now he just needs Stasis Shield and then that's apparently him learned everything that's possible. I already have a second cell. Come on, retaliation mission, I want to mess with some chrysalids because I hate them. Oh, so we got a plasma blaster. We've devised a means of releasing a massive focused pulse of plasma energy that will devastate targets in a fixed path. So I think this is like a non-Psy operative version of Null Lance, and it sounds amazing. we got all the supplies. Ignore for now. So we have enough supplies, we just need the power relay to finish working and then we're done. The retaliation event is going to trigger, but I guess we'll fly back to that relay and that should make it happen.
Brazil.
You would have been quicker going that way, but whatever. You don't need me to tell you the layout of the world, you live here. Come on, finish before the retaliation. You SOB. Okay. So, there's 11 enemies, Berserker, Chrysalid, Andromedan. No Sectapod, so that's positive. But we do have Chrysalids, which are obviously a pain in the arse. Anyway, let's go save some people. Or, you know, die trying. Also, I hear the dog crying, so she must have seen the postman. So, retaliation mission. We don't need to worry about Sectapods, so therefore we can maybe give Lenoria a miss this mission. Also, Soul Food is not in the list, so... No, he can come. We'll bring our Soul Food. I guess we could bring two Assaults. I think for a retaliation mission, I think I would rather have two Heavies. So, let's select me. Even though I'm max rank. Now... I've still got the Flamethrower equipped, right? Yeah, let's get rid of the Flamethrower and let's take the Plasma Blaster. So the damage goes up to 7 to 10, range is 25, which is actually lower than the Flamethrower. Radius 12 though. It's a one-time thing. There wasn't a Codex on this mission though. Flashbangs still have use outside of Codexes, we'll bring it. I think we're good with this squad. Let me just, hang on, is there anyone who else needs ranked up? Yeah, Nick needs ranked up still, so we'll bring him instead of Amy. Again, this is a very dark screen for some reason. It's almost as if the brightness setting isn't applying. Alright, we might fail this purely because enemies spawn too close to a bunch of civvies. If we do, nothing I can do about it. As long as we don't lose anybody.
Sky Ranger deployed. In position for deployment.
But it has been a little while. I've got to remember, if Chrysalids kill anybody, they turn into cocoons and the cocoons need to be killed. Also, if you mind control a Chrysalid and you kill someone, the cocoon that gets made from that will not be on your side. Cursed Heat. Yeah, there's some Cursed Heat right there. Emancipation Cove.
We're going in to eliminate the enemy threat and secure the area.
We can do this. It just depends on the number of Chrysalids to the number of bullets. If the number of bullets is higher, we win. That was a pretty quick load. Geronimo! Dragon X is just phasing through a rock there.
Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking.
Well,
the
we've got two civvies real close, so that's positive.
And protect those civilians.
But one of them could be a faceless.
So did we.
You won't ha! You say that, Bradford. But Nick said no. That's what he has to say about your concealment. Actually, Soviet can probably reach this guy this turn. If it's a faceless, we can deal with the faceless.
I'm on it.
Sounds like he saw a squad as well.
Let's go, move out.
Right? Because the music started. Yeah. Berserker and two Chrysalids. Right, that's like that's perfect that he saw them with the very first move I did. What is bad is it sent the other civvy running. So I think we're going to be doing Void Rift to end his turn. Because he could catch all three of them? Yeah, he could. Just remember, if I mind control anybody, it's not permanent.
The rift opens.
Yeah, it does. Rift the shit out of them. A little bit of damage. Any status effects? No panics, because it would have triggered before the animation finished. I've mind controlled one of them, by the looks of it. Or I debuffed him somehow? Oh, Rupture does extra damage. Oh, he's pissed. Good. As far as first turns go, it's going rather swimmingly so far, because if the Chrysalids are coming after me, they're not going after civvies. 99% chance, 100% chance. 100% chance to remove the Chrysalid problem, please. There will be more on the map, though, for sure. Alright, so Berserker shouldn't be a problem. Also shouldn't need to waste any of my heavier weapons. We'll just shoot him. What is your buff here? Is there any way for me to actually check that? Oh yeah, there we go, hang on. Enraged gains bonus mobility. So it doesn't actually increase his damage, it just means he can move further. Okay. That's not going to save you from plasma to the gut though. It's got 2 HP left, I think. Oh, 4. I always misjudge how much HP they have. So, who hasn't max rank? Yeah, hasn't got max rank. Dragonakis hasn't and Nick hasn't, but I'd quite like to maintain Nick's stealth for now.
I hope it's worth it.
So we'll try and get a pistol kill. Dragonakis misses or just doesn't do enough damage, then Nick can get it. No, 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 fire pistol. There we are. Minimum damage is 3 actually, so yeah, we're fine. Pistol that.
One down, thousands to go.
Yep, one down, thousands to go. I actually forgot I hadn't done anything either. So what skill did I get again? Cone Chip Barrage, every enemy. In addition, cover those enemies as damage is destroyed. Yeah. Not particularly useful this turn.
Copy that.
So assuming there's not another squad nearby, there's 3 civvies we can rescue really, really quickly. And that's very positive.
Go, go, go. Hold in position.
Oh yeah, you've got the thing there where if you end a turn without Overwatch, you just hunker down. So that's plus 20 defense or 30 defense. Ah, there is a nearby squad. What is... Oh, the Andromedan. That poor civvy, I mean, he was dead before he hit the floor. So actually, in terms of ways to die, that's probably for the best. No, we're not Bradford. Shut your ugly face. I'll also bring back your old voice actor. So there is another squad right nearby. Well, my ideal move again would be to trigger them with the very first move I make, because then they'll just come towards me. So ideally, Soul Food's going to trigger them right here. And he did, because the music started. Also, what was that? Is that a faceless? What happened there? Some kind of pop-up appeared on the civvy. Also, I think I heard the door. Give me 1 second. I did, but the postman didn't seem to have anything for me today. Yeah, that a green thing popped up on the civvy there, and she moved there. So we'll probably be using stasis this turn, almost certainly. But I'd very much also like to try out this plasma blaster. But I need to get you in a position. The bloody civvy stole my full cover. Oh, I could force her to move with someone else first. Like maybe CR. Because then you could just lob a grenade. Yeah, the one that doesn't need line of sight. Yeah, absolutely.
I can handle that.
Right, civvy, piss off.
You're clear, go!
So now I can move to that full cover. And we're going to be doing the bomb, blaster bomb. Now, he ran off. I guess I want to hit the two people with... Can I get all three of these? Is that hitting all three? I want to hit the two with armor more so than the guy who... Oh god, it's making FPS lag like a bitch. I think that's hitting all three right there.
Locked on!
Wee dead. Good damage. I think the shield, yeah, the shield bearer outright died. Good. Okay, so Yuki, you don't really need XP, but I wouldn't mind you getting a pot shot at somebody.
Not a problem.
You have shots. 38% chance on the Lancer, 81% on the Andromedan. Take that. Good. I might get him down to second form before our stasis. Yeah, we're saving your turn. So this is Nick, who's still concealed. Let's go to me, and I want to move up to the full cover here. Oh, I bet I can't, because Soul Food's going to be in the way of this new attack. Because it is like a flamethrower. Oh no, it's more like a beam. But no, I can't, because Soul Food would get caught. Alright, we'll save it for the next squad. I guess we'll just fire? Yeah, we'll just fire, because even if I don't... If I miss, he's getting stasis either way. Be it this form or his next one. There's another civvy in the distance there.
That's right.
I would very much like to kill the shield bearer, though. The shock trooper, I mean, because he is a pain in the arse. Who have I got left? Nick, who's concealed. Dragonakis. Well, actually, I could do killzone with Dragonakis, and then if the shield bearer runs out to try and attack someone in close range, he'd get a free shot. Can you end a turn with Killzone after you move? I guess we're going to find out.
It's clear.
Ha, no you can't. Well, you're going to pistol Overwatch, because I would rather you take a shot at the shield bearer. I guess Nick will move there. He might get a shot, and he'll have a good chance to hit because he's still classes concealed. 60%, or I could actually guarantee it with hail of bullets. I'm going to guarantee it. Goodbye. This is going swimmingly so far.
Kill confirmed. They've got eyes on me.
Oh, implacable, you get your free move. Yeah, sure. Maybe I should have left you in full cover, actually. Doesn't matter. And we'll be stasising Mr. Phase 2 Andromedan Shell. So there's two civvies over there, assuming neither are faceless, and that'll put us at, what, 4 out of 6? Oh, ah, there's a gatekeeper. Never mind, one of the civvies just got annihilated at long range. Not Hannah Hagen! Well, hopefully we can still save that civvy before she gets annihilated. We'll move up and fire with Yuki just to do a little bit of damage. Don't want to get the kill shot, though. Missed. A 91% chance to hit.
Come on.
Could have been better. If I move you there. I want the gatekeeper to see me, ideally, but at the same time I'd probably prefer if I could get a surprise on him. And as long as we kill all the enemies, it doesn't matter how many civvies I failed to save, as long as it's not... Well, as long as at least 6 are alive on the map. So you can see from where you are, but I'd rather move you there. Also, you don't need the XP, do you? Do you, me? Who needs the XP? Dragonakis does. That'll do. So I think the gatekeeper is going to get away with killing someone else this turn. Because I'm just going to kind of position people to annihilate him next turn. Unless CR sees him now. Nope.
Overwatch! I'm on it! Overwatch!
He'll have to come a little bit closer. Oh, not if he goes into there to kill someone. Oh, there's someone right up there for him to go after as well. Alright, we have to make sure this guy sees us this turn.
Civilians left and right, Commander. We need to get these people out of here.
Bradford, why don't you grab a gun and you come and help? Oh, there's a squad. Hello there. Is he part of the gatekeeper squad? I don't think so, because they're too far apart. We weren't counted as concealed, by the way. That's why he was able to dodge. Are you actually hitting the commander? Because it looks like you're supposed to be hitting something else that no one can see. He's also kind of just looking listfully up at that sign. It looks like they might be part of the gatekeeper squad, because there's only two of them. Oh, there is 3 civvies over there. Nice. Why are you not dead? So, there's a shield bearer on the map, so you know what that means. That's my ideal target for my control. Is that cover? That's not cover. I mean, I could just walk up and poke him in the face with a sword. Yeah. Let's go and poke him in the face. Hello there, my friend. Lightsaber, bitch.
Taken care
also, we get loot.
This one might be carrying something.
Advanced extended mag. The weapon upgrade will increase ammunition and advanced speed. That's a crap one. Well, better than nothing. And you're in full cover, so I'm not going to take advantage of the free move. Actually, yes, I am, so you can save that civvy. Don't be a faceless.
Go.
Yeah, I assume there wouldn't be any enemies over here because... Oh, that's the squad with the gatekeeper. That's actually perfect. Also, the gatekeeper took a really weird route. So that civvy I moved Nick next to with my free move didn't get rescued, right? She ran away. Or did she get rescued? Weird. Alright, so we do have a lot of enemies on the field right now. I want to mind control a shield bearer. I can currently see the shield bearer, and it's 100% chance. I mean, he's not in a great position, but if he acts as a bullet sponge, that's fine. I just like that it's 100% chance. Why does something appear there? It's weird. So we know that the gatekeeper's coming round there past that civvy, which is unfortunate. And I have no line of sight with CR from here, eh? Well, oh, that doesn't reach. Where can I move you? If I move you there, you might see the gatekeeper, I guess.
Whatever you say.
You can see the gatekeeper. Closed state. The gatekeeper shell is closed. It's more resistant to damage in this state. I didn't even know it could have an opened state. So that kind of scares me. No, I don't want to shoot the shield bearer that I own, thanks. It's a minus 35% because of his closed shell. Still, he is going to get a chance to do something this turn. I hope that he's going to go after the shield bearer. Now, Yuki. What could Yuki do? Cover is not good here. Thinking maybe aid protocol, but aid protocol who? CR in case the gatekeeper shoots him, or Nick in case the shield bearer and this guy tries to hit him? I don't know. Well, what I could do for sure is, well, I could flashbang, or I could do the plasma blaster on somebody. That's not hitting him. I'm beginning to regret taking this weapon. It doesn't seem very good in terms of, like, radius and what have you. Now, obviously, if I did this, the gas bomb would hit my own shield tripper. So, I'm thinking I know this would also flashbang my own shield tripper, but it might also save his life. We're going to flashbang them. The gatekeeper is going to get a chance to do whatever he wants this turn, and that's obviously scary, because I've never let them attack me yet, as far as I'm aware. Oh, it didn't actually affect mine. It looks like the cover protected him, because he hasn't lost any HP. I also forgot I had salvo, so I can get to do something else. Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Yuki is just going to overwatch. Hang back, because I might need to use restoration. Who can you see? You can see the gatekeeper, thanks to squad sight. And you're holo targeted. Go for it. Go for the damage. No, not on my shield tripper. You know, the game should understand the difference between a mind control from the one that isn't permanent and the one that is, so that it doesn't try and make you target the one that you have control of for literally the rest of the match. We did almost get him. Looks like he might be shooting a sieve. Oh, that's perfect. Oh, never mind. That's less than perfect. It's a faceless! Elite Trooper is disorientated, Shield Bearer is disorientated. Oh, yes, Maya, I know you want out. There you go. She was sitting quite nicely and then just wanted out. Please get the kill. Well, at least she still did one, even though it was a miss. Oh, Yuki's still got an overwatch. That should trigger, right? No. Oh, it opened! Oh god, it's a tentacle monster. If it's going to do some kind of side attack, at least Soulfood has, like, his buffs and whatnot. Okay. That's terrifying. It doesn't matter because he's dead next turn anyway, but Jesus Christ, I'm glad I've never let them fire until now. He also takes more damage now that he's opened up. So yeah, we will be doing restoration for sure, and we'll hopefully be running my shield bearer over to buff me. Yeah, go after me, not the civvies. Are you just going to point or are you going to attack? You can't kill him this turn anyway, so it's fine. Is that supposed to hurt? Wait, they're getting turns? No. I should bloody hope not. Alright, so we'll be opening with restoration. To make what the gatekeeper did null and void. And let's never let them do that again. And priority number one is the gatekeeper, priority number two is the faceless. Explosive barrel. Ooh. I'd rather hit that with someone who wants XP, because this could get, well, the gatekeeper kill for sure, and then maybe another one. What about Dragonakis? What kind of shots have you got? Is kills on the right play here? No, because all those zombies are going to die this turn. Oh, you also can't see the barrel. Can Nick see the barrel? Apparently not. How weird. Oh, my shield bearer. Maybe he can. Yeah, he can, but I don't want him to get XP. I want him to run back and buff my troops, but he's probably not going to live that long. I mean, I can see it, right? But I need to reload, but it's a free reload. Also, I could just salvo, and then I still get a chance to do something else. I mean, I know these zombies are going to be dead either way. I'm just curious if I can maybe... Yeah, why not? I get a free action.
Frago!
Doesn't hit any civvies because it would have warned me if it was going to. Goodbye. Then he falls over dead as well.
They're toast.
Goodbye. Then I do my free reload.
Ready to go.
And... Would that reach you? It would reach you. Would this reach you? That does not reach you by one square. Gas bomb would, but then I would also hit my... Well, hang on, I could move my controlled shield bearer, and then I think I can catch both them, right? No, I can't get the one at the back. Alright, well, hang on. You, run back to here. Oh, I wasn't paying attention that someone was on Overwatch. Luckily, he's a stormtrooper. Well, he's disoriented, so, you know. All of a sudden, your health got restored for some reason. Who would you catch with this right now? You'd probably only just catch him and Nick. If we move CR... Oh, there's no cover nearby. Well, obviously, you need to take advantage of your free reload, so do that.
Ready to go.
And get into cover, just in case one of the advents shoot at you, and then shoot the faceless in his face. That's not the faceless! Oh, for God's sake, game! I really hate that.
Impressed yet?
No, I'm not. I'm annoyed at bad design. What's your chances to hit these guys? 50-50, I can make it better. I'd rather just rocket your cover away, actually.
Bring in the pain.
Didn't chip any of his armor, though, because it didn't fully take away the shield, but at least he's in the open now, so it forces a move. So who's left? My other turn and Soulfood. I still can't get that in there to get two of them, but it would limit where the other guy could move, because the poison cloud would be in the way, so yeah, do that. I think I'm going to have to stasis the faceless, which is a pain in the arse, because of... bad target priority on the overlay. He's dead now thanks to poison actually, so that's perfect. His shield's gone next turn. So who can you only see? You can only see the faceless. Does Inspire end your turn? Inspire does end your turn. Does Stasis end your turn? Stasis does not end your turn.
Armor of the mind.
Keep him out of the picture for this turn, and then I'm going to hopefully explode the grenade of the guy who is still alive, if I can. If it'll let me. That is not the guy. Well, now I could end my turn with Inspire, of course, or maybe Nolan's. Nah, he's miles away. Well, I will Inspire me, I guess, just to go on Overwatch, close to where the Advent Trooper is likely to run. Assuming he can't get to me, he'll shoot from where he is, probably, because he can't get through the poison without getting poisoned. Oh, forgot we had this. Well, in that case, we'll definitely try and get a kill zone on him too. He's running away, potentially to join another squad if one still exists. But I think these will be the last two enemies. I don't like how many wounded we're going to have after this mission purely because of one attack from a gatekeeper. He's gone to kill the civvy, and he missed him! You tried to be a dick right at the end and you failed. Yeah, I know, you're pointing twice, but that's not going to save you. And Faceless is back active now. Okay, let's try and do the shot with CR I wanted to do last time, but the game said no. Thank you. That should have happened last turn. And I should all have, like, shield buffs right now, but no. I would like to use this new equipped weapon I have just to see what it does. So I'm just going to kind of like put myself there and hope that I can hit the guy. Does going into this end your turn? Yeah.
This is gonna be hot.
This is gonna be hot. I mean, it is a railgun essentially, so that's kind of cool. There's a faceless, right? That's why it did that. Yeah. He'll be the last enemy then if he's triggering. Also, he looked like Trevor from GTA 5.
I'm a faceless. I'm gonna come eat you.
Are you though? Are you really?
Moving to position.
Just set an overwatch trap to finish off this guy.
On overwatch.
And since it's a faceless cover, it doesn't matter. So we're gonna rescue 10 and lost 3. That's a pretty good ratio. Let's stand on my poor shield bearer who shouldn't be dead. But let's also just guarantee our overwatch is gonna be a good one by doing concealment overwatch.
On overwatch.
This guy isn't getting to us. I stand by the statement that he will not get to us, even though the first one was a miss. There's a good hit. That's like half of HP, over half. Oh, you're stopping there. It's not going to trigger the rest. He's pointing at CR. I'm not sure what he means by that. So, max rank. Doesn't have ranks anymore. Max rank. Not max rank. That will poison you.
Okay.
There's some XP for you. Other than that, one gatekeeper attack, fairly easy mission. And now I obviously know, don't let gatekeepers do that attack ever again.
The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
10 out of 13. Not bad. And we got some loot, although it's not really that great. 90.91% success rate. New record for enemies killed per turn. 2.29. I mean, I think all those zombies helped. We also kind of lucked out that there was only two chrysalids on the map and we saw them immediately, because they obviously have the chance to exponentially multiply on terror missions. Good either way. I also forgot that Dragonakis now gets more aim and crit if he doesn't move between turns, so I'll need to keep that in mind. Back to base, please. I'm good to go. I want to know how many people are wounded and for how long. It better just be wounded. Although even if it is gravely, they're not that bad now that I have the AWP. Or whatever it's called. The Advanced Warfare Center, AWC. That's fine. They'll be back in like a week, tops. No upgrades though. Promotions, I mean.
Hello, Commander.
Hello. Income increased by 21 supplies. Yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, how long have we knocked out for? 5 days, 4 days, 4 days. They'll all be back for the next mission, so that's fine. Good, and we have plenty of supplies, so it's just a case of waiting for this power relay to finish next time, and then we'll probably be able to finish the, or, you know, carry on with the main story. Come back for that later. Ta-da for now.